if you're not appropriately licensed under the state laws that Dana explained, and if you're not appropriately registered with Vincent. And so if you can't resolve those two issues in the activity, then do you look at commodity next? And I guess if you look at commodity, what's the result of that analysis?
So I have she's asking for a legal interpretation. I like to give a practical interpretation. And my practical interpretation is this. We recently received a historic ruling in the Cripsy case where 11,000 bitcoins were ordered by a federal court judge returned to the investors who the money was stolen from. So regardless of whether it's a security, whether it's money, whether it's a commodity, how can we get those people who lost their money, and what are the laws to protect those people where the money was stolen from? And regulation, those investors who believe they were dealing with a decentralized authority, they understood what they were doing, but now that their money's missing, and they consider it money. They're not saying, well, all of a sudden that's Bitcoin, it's not real money. At 4,000 of Bitcoin, that's real money now. There are early adopters who in 2008, 2009, 2010, they lost a lot of money. So I think the question as to what it is from a regulatory standpoint is, if you have money in the bank, we can go get that money in the bank. With Bitcoins, I don't care what you call it, an investor who has Bitcoin stolen considers that money and they want their money back. So from my perspective, it becomes, how are the laws and what are the regulations? We can talk about FinCEN, we can talk about the SEC, we can talk about DOJ. At the end of the day, as you're putting your companies together, as you're investing in cryptocurrencies and you're doing businesses, we all appreciate this. You're doing it to make money. You're not doing this for any other reason. If you're starting a token, you're doing an ICO. The purpose is to make money, for that ICO to go up in value, and for you to cash out. And at that point, it's money. So from my perspective, you tell me how I get those 11,000 bitcoins back, because I can't do it right now. If anyone in this room can, you can let me know.
Okay, I would like to add, though, it is important to resolve the money, the currency issue, or, you know, is it monetary value that you're transmitting? Because if it is, the government can beat you to that money, because if you're not appropriately licensed, not appropriately registered, it's a predicate act for the asset forfeiture statute, so the government can seize that value first.